been a tricky thing to find a play that suits for the junior play, because the people who are auditioning are of a certain age, and this particular year with an early Easter, it meant it was a very slow, short lead-in time. We didn't get a chance to even sort of think about it before Christmas. So the idea came up to do two discrete one-act plays with two separate small casts that could be rehearsed fairly promptly and give some sort of variety as well.
So the play's about a hotel fire, and it's quite absurd because as the hotel's burning down, they don't really care. Like, they're kind of talking about packing and wondering if they'll get another room, and it's just quite funny.
Here you are. Thank you, sir. We'll have to get out of here pretty soon.
I'm Bob, who's someone staying in a hotel, and I have to act quite calmly and pretend I don't really care about the fire that's happening, and I start thinking about other things, like packing, other than the fire.
I say that is pretty bad. Hey, you really ought to see this.
My favourite part in the play is probably when the firemen come in and one of the firemen starts tuning up his violin.
How is the fireman?
Oh, no better. This wall here will go pretty soon, but it will fall out that way. So, it's all right. The next room is really the place to fight it from.
So, people in the play are just carrying on regardless of the fire that's on the floor below. Just as, like, no one is really taking action against, say, big issues like global warming and stuff like that. I also think it's sort of symbolic of Nero playing the fiddle while Rome burned, because certainly, like, at the end, there's actually a bit where I play the violin while the hotel is burning down and no one is making an effort to fight the fire. The tune I actually play is called Keep the Home Fires Burning, which was, I think it was used in the First World War to just keep morale up among the soldiers.
Антон Чехов – один из моих любимых писателей, и я прочитала огромное количество его произведений, у него очень много коротких рассказов, и «Вишневый сад» – это абсолютно выдающееся чтиво в свободное время, и я всем, конечно, рекомендую прочитать Чехова, потому что он один из самых выдающихся писателей XIX века и вообще русских писателей.
It's an interesting play with humour involved, and it's a one actor which fitted the bill as well. So it perhaps isn't quite the regular idea of a Chekhov play, which is a little bit more sort of stuffy, stilted perhaps for some people, but it works as a three-hander pretty well, and everyone gets a fair bite of the apple, if you know what I mean, in terms of lines and time on stage.
Соответственно, эта пьеса называется «Предложение», и это шутка в одном действии. Это такая комедия, в которой мужчина пытается сделать предложение молодой девушке, но у него не получается, потому что они постоянно ссорятся. Вот. Это вкратце.
Who is this I see, my dear fellow, Ivan Vasilievich? Oh, I'm so glad to see you, but this is a surprise. How are you?
Thank you, and how are you?
So-so, my dear fellow, so-so. Oh, please do sit down. It isn't right to forget one's neighbour after all. But tell me, why all the ceremony? I mean, dress clothes, everything. Are you on your way to some engagement, my dear fellow?
No, I have no engagement except with you, Stepan Stepanovich.
Stepan Stepanovich, or, Trubukov. He's quite confident. He's obviously quite old, judging by the makeup, which takes ages to put on.
Well, here it is then. I've come to ask for the hand of your daughter, Natalia Stepanovna.
It's been my dearest wish.
I have always loved you, my dear fellow. As my own son. Oh, may God give you his blessings and his grace. And oh, I've wanted it to happen for the longest time, but oh, I'm standing here like a blockhead. I'm completely dumbfounded with pleasure. Completely dumbfounded. My whole being. Uncle Natalia.
Stepan Stepanovich, what do you think? May I hope for Natalia Stepanovna's acceptance?
Really? A fine boy like you and you think she won't accept on the minute?
Ooh, favorite part? That's hard to say. I think some of the scenes where me and Nikki are together where we're kind of yelling about Ivan Vasilievich, but that's probably my favorite. That's probably one of my favorite moments.
But this fool dares to make a proposal of marriage. Yes. Yes.
What? A proposal of marriage?
Well, that's why he had on his evening clothes, the poor fool.
A proposal for me? Oh! I like the play. It's kind of interesting. Like, it's a bit weird the way we're always arguing, and hopefully people find it funny.
You have any manners, you brutal! If it weren't for you, we wouldn't have gone in the first place!
Oh yes, I'm to blame. And remember, if I shoot or hang myself, you'll be to blame! You forced me to it, you! There!
So we just decided to see if we could get it to step outside, perhaps it's normal. I don't know what its normal thing would be, but it's kind of commedia dell'arte sort of makeup style, giving them almost a mask to play with. So it, once the players got the makeup on in the dress rehearsal, it actually gave them a different lift and a different take on acting against somebody else with that kind of maybe a little bit more stylized. But there could be an element of the player hiding behind a mask and then creating something beyond that. But it certainly wouldn't have been the norm for a Chekhov play or anything of his time.
Probably the part where Ross and I are both complaining about Nevin. It's about halfway through and we're both just screaming about him. And it's the part that I know my line's the best in, so I really enjoy it.
Everybody knows that... Oh, my heart, my legs, the head of my temples. I'm dying. The doctor! Baby, half-baked clown fool!
Nice to the punter you are. You can't even ride around on a horse. What's the matter with him? Ivan Vasilievich! He is dead!
I'm ill. I can't breathe.
The thing about it was, this particular time around, Guys and Dolls had been quite an intense thing, and we think we'd had up to 35 people involved in terms of pupils. And then when I looked at the Green Book and I saw very early February and a quick turnaround. It was possibly an element of, right, what can we do that'll preserve our energy levels and that we can make a decent stab at, but actually not run us into the ground. So other plays for the junior play have been more involved, and I imagine next year we'll try and make some sort of extravaganza.
Kiss each other.